question 28, I'm jumping a little bit ahead to address some of the questions that are coming up. So what have we got going on here? So first we're going to solve this equation for theta, and then we're going to want the, we'll look for the different values where we get that between 0 and 2 pi on the unit circle. So first of all, we've got 2 cosine of theta minus 1 equals 0. So we can add 1 to both sides. Or again, the goal is to isolate theta. That's what we're solving for. So we add 1 to both sides. We get 2 cosine theta equals positive 1. We divide both sides by 2. So then we get cosine theta equals 1 half. Take the inverse cosine, which means that we're looking what angle of theta gives us a cosine value of 1 half. And that's where having the unit circle is very helpful. Where is cosine 1 half? Well, here it is right here at 1 third. But look at this. So we start at this. The first place it happens is at pi over 3, not 1 third, pi over 3, 60 degrees. That's one place. But we keep going around. Where's another place x is 1 half? Well, whoa, right over here. But over here it's a negative 1 half, so that don't count. We keep coming around. There's another negative 1 half. That don't count. And let's see, that's on the x. We're looking on the x. But we come over to the fourth quadrant. Here's cosine. The x is 1 half, positive 1 half, at 5 pi over 3. So the two places, pi over 3, positive 1 half, and 5 pi over 3. So those are the two places, the two values of theta that give us a value of 1 half. You plug those both in, you get 1 half. There's two values that would give us negative 1 half, but we're not counting those. Okay, now I want to just jump ahead a little bit. If this question was not asking in the interval, if they wanted all the different ones, notice you come to pi over 3. If you add 2 pi to it, you're back at pi over 3. You add another 2 pi, you're back at this place. So you could keep going around multiple times. So we've got to also, so these questions that come up about when do you add 2 pi, this one you'd have to add 2 pi, and you'd also have to add 2 pi to there. But look at this, these angles are not across from each other, so adding pi would not give us an answer. So you're going to see whenever you have sine or cosine and they're asking for an infinite number of solutions, generally that's where you're going to add 2 pi. When you have tangent, we're going to see that's usually when you add pi. In this particular question, they just wanted on this interval, so these are the two, right? These are the two answers. That's all there is. So if that kind of confused you, just you'll see soon. I'm sure you've seen those questions as you come. But there are some questions that don't give us the interval. That means they want them. There's an infinite number of questions, right? Because we can go around the circle all day long and longer. So 3. There we go. But on just the one trip around the circle, there's just these two places where the cosine of theta is equal to 1 half.